We like it.
What's on the agenda for today? The business that I run is Baby Phat Jean Company. Who said the meeting was at 4 o'clock? I'd like to know so I can fire them. I'm a fashion girl. I've had a 40-foot version of myself in Times Square. I've had billboards. That's my life. But at the end of the day, it's me and my girls. Yoki, you're such a good little executive.
Who is this? Looks like Kimora.
That's my Barbie doll. I'm going to make a Kimora Lee Simmons Barbie. I don't like your concepts, James, and your photo shoot is right around the corner. When it comes to an ad campaign, every season is the most important thing of your life.
We're 2.5 months into planning an ad campaign, and there's not one thing to shoot.
What we have on our hand is a catastrophe.
I'm screaming because this is just a joke.
You want to quit, quit.
As the CEO of Baby Phat, I design clothing, jewelry, fragrances, you name it. It's a lot of work, but I've come a long way since my days walking the runway. I'm a mogul and a model, and best of all, I'm a mom. I'm Kimora Lee Simmons, and this is my life in the fab lane.
Don't touch my teddy bear. Had a dog or something taken him and chewed him up, or anything could have happened. That's why he's up there. Someone moved him. So please walk him, housekeeper to housekeeper, and shake it out of him, whoever touched my teddy bear.
Oh, you want to find out
who? Oh, yeah, because they need to know. Don't touch him. Everyone's going to be like, oh, I didn't do it. That's going to be the end of the thing. My goal is whoever did it.
You want
to? Don't touch it. That's the goal. So we can't just reprimand.
Oh, but I can touch it to show it.
No, sir, you cannot actually. You should bring him in.
Okay.
I think I'm like your normal everyday person. I have issues and kids and family and jobs to balance. I'm normal and I'm not normal. Ming? Good morning to you.
Mama, we wanted to have a slumber party last night.
I see. Come on, we have to get up and go down for breakfast. We send you off with a nutritional start so that your brain can pump, 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 and think, 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 and your muscles get work, 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 and your legs get go, 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 go. I'm a normal mom. I'm not quite a soccer mom, but when they get a little older, I'll probably be a ballet carpool mom or something. Maybe we should scratch the carpool thing. Let's really face it, I'm not having all those kids tearing up my car, and I'm not really having my kids going in a bunch of different cars, so let's forget. Forget the carpool thing. Forget that. We have a driver. Hi, Hassan.
Working for Ms. Simmons is great. It's a real home feeling. We're all a big family. Normally, I make things that I know she likes. I've been doing this for a while now, so I kind of know what she likes.
Hassan, what did you put in my fruit and yogurt parfait?
There's mango in there. There's a little bit of kiwi.
I don't like mango, and I don't like kiwi. I want a waffle. Yeah, that's right up my alley. These waffles really make me happy.
Do we make you happy too, Mama?
You make me happier than the waffles.
Good.
I love being a mom. That's the best part of my life. Cars come and go. Money comes and goes. Husbands come and go.
Bye.
But the kids don't come and go.
Do look so sad.
Give me a titty.
Mama, that's my Barbie.
Those are very neat. You know, Mommy's gonna be a Barbie.
I trained to make it.
I'm going to make a Barbie that is called a Me Barbie, a Kimora Lee Simmons Barbie. Are you excited?
Yes.
Bye, guys. I love you. Strap yourselves in. I am a mother, a businesswoman, an entrepreneur. I am a mogul. I'm crazy. I'm loud. I'm stressed and tired. I guess my hair is okay, right? The front piece, the front, that and that?
Yeah, I like it.
Okay. Sandra travels with me on a day-to-day basis. So when I'm actually at the fashion show or at the photo shoots, you know, wherever I am, Sandra goes with me.
What's on the agenda for today?
Today we have a meeting with James to review the ad campaign.
Yes, which we're shooting in LA, right?
Yes.
When it comes to an ad campaign, every season is the most important thing of your life. So you always want to top yourself, and you always want to improve and grow and create new things, and you know, it's always like a clincher.
What else is on the schedule?
Tina wants to run through Barbie with you.
I got a Barbie doll. That's big.
So it's ready, the doll?
Somewhat ready for approval, not the final product.
Good answer, Sandy.
Okay, so July 10th, QVC.
Is that confirmed?
Yes.
I don't even think that's true. Are you sure?
The last time they said that was confirmed.
Jack. Hi, I'm going over my schedule, and they tell me that Tuesday the 10th is QVC in Pennsylvania. You're definitely, no? Exactly, that's what I just told you. QVC has been postponed. It's not on the schedule. You know what? You guys are not gonna do my life like this. You handle the schedule from now on.
That's like 500 emails a day about the schedule.
You guys are not gonna handle me. You're gonna be handled. The business that I run is Baby Phat Jean Company. Under that, it divides into so many things. Jeans, shoes, fragrance, jewelry, sunglasses. My kids' little businesses, their fashion shows. It's a lot of subdivisions that really do stand on their own as well. It's my job to oversee every facet of this empire. I'm responsible for everything. Did you know that July 10th, we were supposed to shoot QVC?
Yes.
Did you know that that had been removed off the schedule?
Yes.
Sandra didn't even know it was off the schedule. First of all, I told her to handle the schedule. She told me no. Do y'all tell me or do I tell y'all? That's first of all. But we have a problem. I'm having a really bad day. I'm trying to diet. I can't find a proper pill. The granola's not cutting it. I'm hungry. I don't know what to eat. I'm irritated. I would be just much happier fat. I feel very Anna Nicole Smith right now. Rest in peace, her beautiful soul. She likes pink like I like pink. But I'm just not having a good day. I'm hot. Honestly, probably because I don't eat. I was on my period last week. I'm just a little flustered, okay? I'm glad you're so calm today. Your office smells nice. You must have got some last night.
No.
At least that's one of us.
You gotta eat something to eat. Do you want a bar?
Yes. And everyone that works around me is very young. I gave them an opportunity, just like someone gave me an opportunity. Everybody rise. Look, nobody moved. Except for my baby James. Because James knows when the brown knows and when not. James got right up.
Okay, let's talk about the advertising campaign, because that is right around the corner.
Okay. So as you guys know, we're all going to be working on this 2007 Fall Winter ad campaign, and there's a lot to do.
James is like an in-house ad executive, but he also creatively handles everything that has to do with the production of the ad as well.
We're waiting for an estimate from the ad campaign costs from Chandelier.
And right. You're gonna stay on top of that because Alex and them, they wanna sell me the moon and then charge
right.
me double.
Yes, I know. And we're gonna try to keep under budget this season, and we've padded the budget by $75,000, so there's money left over.
All right, we're a family, that's what it is. We're all young, contemporary, creative people. And together we sort of make the team work. Okay, great. I would just like us to join hands, everyone. I'm serious. I would just like to say thank you so much. I love you all. And let's, while we're joining hands, ask for God to help us to continue to be creative and innovative. So let's just be thankful that we have one another, even though at times we bicker and fight. But underneath it all, hopefully it's love. And on top of it all, certainly it's fabulosity.
Amen. Praise Jesus.
James is on his way up to talk about the ad campaign, but let's see what we have on Barbie while we're waiting.
So these, this just came in.
The Kimora Barbie was Mattel's idea. And I thought to what Barbie already stands for, I could add a little bit of fabulosity.
You know, the world is talking to me about my Barbie. I really hope she represents a proper ethnic blend. Do you feel like she does?
I like it.
I'm a fashion girl. You're like a living, you know, doll sometimes. I kind of feel like I'm a living Barbie, which is so great for me to be making a Barbie doll.
Does this look like Zoe?
No, they need to fix that.
And what about the quality of this coat? Because I know it's faux chinchilla, but it looks like rat.
I'll provide them with a swatch.
I think she looks good.
So I'm gonna call Mattel and I'll set up a meeting for LA.
Okay. Hi, James. That's good, Jamesy. You need that.
The next thing is dealing with our new ad campaign. What I was thinking, right, and I wanted to hear your thoughts on this was, is that...
Don't make me bust out a nail file on you. Talk faster.
I really you know I don't work well under pressure.
All right,
here,
go ahead.
Okay? I'm going to run from you if you start breaking out nail clippers.
Go ahead.
What I do think that we should do is to shoot maybe 6 or 7 photos that highlight, you know, different contents of your collection, which would be shoes, footwear, jewelry, sunglasses, loungewear.
Get to the concept.
The concept is From Russia with Love. Things that you associate with Russia that you love,
caviar,
right?
Caviar, champagne, so,
what
diamonds.
She said, that would be one. Over the top extravagance, meaning czarina, right?
Hurry up, James, you
I'm gonna say, no, look, the entire ad campaign is based on the day in the life of this woman, maybe a Russian czarina that gets captured or gets convicted of a crime. The KGB inquisitions her.
You notice I'm not paying attention to you?
You're not.
It's because you're not catching me.
There's a lot of hard work that went into presenting these ideas today to Kimora about the ad campaign, and sometimes a little disconcerting when she doesn't like things.
Now, I don't like the concepts, James, and your photo shoot is right
this around. This is not full on concepts, these are just ideas.
Je n'aime pas. And James feels really at home with me. I'm like his mom, I'm like everyone's mama. And I teach everyone to go just above and beyond their limitations and be fabulous. James is really creative, and I sort of bring that out in James. I'm not tooting my own horn, but toot toot. This is our ad campaign. We only do 2 a year. It runs in all the major magazines. You're babbling ideas at me. I think that you need to go up to Chandelier. That's why we have an ad agency. And I think you need to get this together, because what we have on our hand is a catastrophe.
Who is this? Looks like Kimora.
That's my Barbie doll.
Why does she not be naked and just so sexy?
Have a seat, guys. What are we discussing?
Today, we show Kimora what the ad campaign has led up to.
I'm not impressed. James is pitching his concepts for the ad campaign to me again today, and this time he's bringing along the ad exec from Chandelier. He knows that this time, the concepts have got to be outstanding. No, I have dogs, you know, they discriminate in the building. I have to come through this entrance.
Hey, little munchkin.
Okay, so what do we have to do? Where's my schedule on my desk I'm supposed to have to tell me what I'm doing?
Your schedule's been changing so much, I don't know how to deal with it.
So how do I know what I'm supposed to work on?
All I know is James and the guys from the ad agency will be here at 2.
Well, at least you know that. Why are they so late? Brandon, can you reorder this for me? I want the chicken on the side, and I want everything else that's in it, but not the lettuce. Put the lettuce separate, and then in another bowl, I want the cucumbers, the chickpeas, the beans, the corn, the tomatoes, the cucumber. Put that in another dish, because I'll eat that. Like right now, I'm ready to throw this away, but I'm fishing out the beans and all that. Hi. Russell and I, we work together. We have a very good relationship. Come over here, let me trim your cuticles.
Messing my cubicle? What about my cubicles?
They're not cubicles.
Whatever
they
are, cubicle, leave me alone.
Russell is definitely one of my mentors. I learned so much from him. He's like a genius.
Who is this? Looks like Kimora.
That's my Barbie doll.
That's amazing.
She looks ethnic, right? I picked fat face, fat lips. I picked a mixture of colored skin.
That's very cool. We love that. This is cool. This is very cool.
But you know how Barbie makes Barbies that are like doctors, lawyers. She's a single mother, entrepreneur, mogul Barbie. Russell's great, and he is a genius, but he's a little kooky too.
Why? She's gotta be naked and just so sexy. She's a doll for children.
That's KLS collection.
Adult
collection.
Oh, clothes.
Yes, we're selling them in Bloomingdale's.
Oh, those Barbie gonna look like this.
No, she is a Barbie.
Why do you gotta have the tightest little miniskirt with the garter belts? Why should she make it like that? It's crazy.
See, that's your problem. And I'm here for you if you wanna talk about it. We've been friends for so long, that's the thing, probably like 15 years at least. And we've built wonderful things in terms of an empire and in terms of a legacy, definitely in terms of our beautiful family and our great kids. Even though he is a great dad, I'm a better dad. Oh, Daddy God. Thinks my Barbie doll is naked. Do you think my Barbie doll is naked?
What do you think, Yoki Lee?
Would you play with it or not?
I would.
We like it.
I like it, Daddy.
Get anything you like, Daddy likes.
Is Chandelier here? They're late. Their meeting was at 2:00. We're using an ad agency called Chandelier that I work with a lot. James knows everything about what I expect for the ad campaign, and now we have to just bring it all together.
Today is the day. Today we show Kimora what 2 months of work has led up to, and hopefully she says yes to it all.
Chandelier's here.
How nice of you all.
Hi.
Hi, Alex. Hi, Richard.
Hi.
How nice of you guys to join us.
Thank you.
Your meeting was at 2:00.
It was at 4:00.
It was not.
They changed it for you and I didn't know.
Our meeting was at 2:00. Who said the meeting was at 4:00? I'd like to know so I can fire them. Who told you the meeting was at 4?
It was originally 4.
Chandelier, that's you. 2 p.m. All right, well, have a seat, guys. What are we discussing? Welcome.
We're gonna go over some ideas for the campaign.
We wanted to get your reaction on some of the images. There's like 6 different concepts.
That's so a lot, right?
All right, so we went with the Russian theme, narrowed it down to a few.
Why does it say the Orient Express?
One take on Russia was this idea of the Trans-Siberian Express. I love the idea of setting it on a train as one of the ideas.
Okay, let's go on to the next one. KGB.
Okay, so we love the idea here of two Kimoras. You're fighting yourself in an ad, so there's two of you, and you're in this fight sequence with yourself.
What does that have to do with Russia?
Well, the interior mood could feel Cold War Russian.
Right, it's very Cold War.
It could feel, you know.
I'm not impressed. Kimora as the icon. Go ahead, tell me about this one.
So I love the idea of pairing you against Russian avant-garde architecture.
How are you going to get iconic architecture if you have a set?
Well, this is a building that we found in Los Angeles yesterday.
Kimora as the icon.
Yeah.
We're doing Kimora as the icon. I love it. I love it. We have to go keep on budget.
Of course.
Every time I do a shoot, they say I'm $30,000 over budget, $50,000 over budget, $80,000 over budget, $250,000 over budget. We can't be over budget. You're messing with my money and my time.
Okay. We came out of this meeting with a creative direction. I think that we all are pretty happy.
I don't know what's wrong with me. It's like I'm on crack. I went to bed at 4. Every night, I'm in the middle of the night, I'm like, let's talk. What are we gonna do? How's life, future? What's going on? And I look at the clock, it's like 4 in the morning. What's wrong with me? I'm stressed and tired, and I have a lot going on. I have a very high voltage, high stress, high pace, high strung life. And Jules comes in and sort of helps you find the serenity in the chaos, and we love him. Jules is sort of a spiritual healer, yoga teacher, yogi, extraterrestrial person.
Bend your knees, just fall back. That's it.
Put your head between my legs.
This is why I'm in page 6. Put your head between my legs.
It looks like we've been robbed. You're not gonna believe what I just witnessed.
What?
The Baby Phat line only consists of sweatsuits, t-shirts, and a few dresses that have absolutely nothing to do with the Russian-inspired theme.
Nothing red, nothing black, nothing gold.
No. We were supposed to do a Russian-inspired themed ad, and now our clothes look like we're going to the Bahamas. We're 2.5 months into planning an ad campaign, and there's not one thing to shoot.
Well, you better think of something.
Lift your legs straight up toward the ceiling. Now here comes the flying.
I thought we were flying all this time.
Yeah, well, this is real flying. Let me let go of my hands.
Jules, I can't!
Go, go, go. Keep your arms straight. Higher. Push. There you go. That's what I want.
Yeah, but I don't want you to let me go.
You can let go yourself.
I can't.
Yes, you can.
That's what I want. Fly, girl. Come on. Fly! Ah. There you go.
Wow.
You see how great it feels to be alive?
Wow.
You were stressed out before, remember? You said, I don't want to do it.
We should do that with all the girls at the office, and the guys at the office.
Sure.
Because we have a lot going on and they're stressed. So if they could de-stress in a few minutes like that, it would probably be great.
Katie, this is James. I'm calling you in regards to the ad campaign. I'm really at a loss as to what it is that we're supposed to be shooting because there's nothing that should inspire. So when you get this message, please call me back as to the solutions that you have for the situation because I really just, I'm at a loss.
So what more could go wrong than not having clothes for a fashion company's ad campaign?
This is just a joke! And do you understand what I'm saying? It's like I'm defending myself for what? I went over to 5:30 just now, going through clothes that were not Russian inspired. Everything is like white, teal, and plum.
We have an entire ad campaign booked around a Russian inspired theme, and we have no clothes that match up to that.
There's no Russian clothes for Baby Phat. Not one article. I mean, unless you consider sweatsuits.
Yeah.
Russian. Unless that's something that I didn't, you know, learn in high school about Russian history.
Unless we want a Baby Phat ad campaign with Kimora starring naked, somebody needs to make some clothes.
I gotta show you something.
Okay.
Basically, the only thing that came good out of today, I don't know if it really goes with the ad campaign anymore, seeing that, you know, the clothes are not Russian inspired, but we'll try to make that happen. I just got sent the location that we're trying to find in LA.
That's beautiful. Where
Isn't
is that?
Mm-hmm.
So is it available when we want to shoot?
Uh-huh.
And okay. It's within our budget?
Yeah. Seeing that you're gonna have to spend another $100,000 on building a line of clothing, probably.
Everybody, this is Jules. Say hi, Jules. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
And I know you guys are working very, very hard trying to get our ad campaign together. We're working on our ad campaign, which we do twice a year. It's like a really big deal. It's like a 2 or 3 day shoot, so everybody's kind of stressed with their concepts and their clothes and their fittings and their locations and their photographers and their hair and their makeup and their catering and their location and their concept.
Wait,
and
let
things.
Me breathe.
So everyone's very stressed.
We are stressed. We're about to lose our minds and jump off the building, you know, holding hands like a cult.
And lift yourself up higher and higher.
That's it, girl. That's so awesome. That's so beautiful.
No.
Yeah.
Exhale, bend your knees, and let your body fall.
He's gonna try to do something and it's gonna break his back. And I don't say I didn't tell you, so I hope you signed an insurance waiver because Lord only knows I am 350 pounds.
Lift your legs up. Lift your legs up.
We love
James.
James, take a deep breath. James, you're gonna make it hurt for me and then I will fall. Yeah, that's better. Just breathe. Let yourself be held for a little while, man. How good is that for you, huh?
Crazy.
Right? You know that to me, you're as light as a feather, right? Take a deep breath. Exhale, put your feet on the ground.
That
look
was
at me.
Crazy.
I want you to look at me. And I want you to understand that that was really easy for me.
Okay.
All right? Great. How do you feel right here? That's what I want to know.
It was a connection.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Because nobody would ever do that. In the right mind, you're crazy, but
no,
it's fabulous.
No, you're fabulous. That's what I'm trying to get through to you. See, it's not about this outer thing that I felt, mm-hmm. right? It's what I felt in here,
thank you.
You know? And I really want to thank you for your trust. All right, because that was big. That was really big.
Is he gonna cry? Don't start that.
Don't
today.
Make
you
me
haven't
cry.
Met him before in your life.
It's all your fault.
That's what he does. It's okay. It's really okay.
It is okay. It's
he makes people cry.
Well, we're getting ready for Los Angeles. We have about 20 to 25 outfits. Normally, to get ready for a trip, Kimora's stylist comes and she lays out the outfits, Polaroids them. We go back, make sure we have everything in each Polaroid, making sure the outfit, if it requires special socks, or make sure the shoes have insoles, etc. Majority of her luggage is Louis Vuitton. She does have probably a little more than what they make at the Louis Vuitton stores, because she even has custom pieces. Like this duffel bag, they don't make that for sale.
This is the light version of how she travels. Like this is, she didn't take that much stuff this time.
Today we have our meeting with Mattel to go over the final details for the KLS Barbie.
Seems like I do final details every other day. When will they really be final? Is James here?
Yeah, I just spoke with him. He's working on the photo shoot.
Do I look fat?
Absolutely not.
I got a gig in California. Gonna make it big in California.
I just got in from New York to LA and trying to get where I'm going, where this Baby Phat warehouse is.
Everybody's a star in California.
I need to find out whether or not they are making any clothes to use in this ad campaign.
It's all about your car in California.
Every time I'm in LA, it's like you try to get somewhere and you get an open patch of cars and then you're back into this mess. It's like, where do these people come from? Where do you live? It's like they're ants coming out of a molehill. It's like, what is going on?
I want that suit with the fishnet, and I want that gown. Just ordering outfits, sorry.
All right, so we just wanted to get together with you today to review our progress so far.
Can we change her at this point? No. Excuse me.
Absolutely.
You can't sit right on my butt. Sit in the chair. Scoot over. Thank you. Don't push her down. Thank you. Scoot back, okay, and be safe.
We just kind of want to show you our work in progress so you can give us some of your feedback and tell us what you think is going to be important.
Okay.
This is just a rough muslin of kind of where we're going with the doll. The colors are incorrect, but just to kind of get the feel of what it's going to look like and the shapes and fit. Doll. These are the working heads. It's not final by any means.
We're in a meeting, you have to pay attention.
So why don't you talk
okay?
her through which one is which. These are actually the same head. These are two different face paints. One has the lavender eyeshadow, one has the more pinkish eyeshadow, which is sort of the color, which is the color of your outfit.
I actually like this color, but no, I like the purple. I think it needs a little more glitter.
That's
a little like drag queen.
We're all about more. Yes. You know, Barbie never has too much color, too much glitter.
The perfect
this is your home. It's like, welcome home.
Yes.
So because the doll is so much about your persona and your image, it might be helpful to call it Kimora Lee Simmons.
Yeah, we want it to be a Kimora Barbie.
Kimora.
You're trying to take that word away from me, and I will not have it. Because I want children to know that there's other colors and textures, and she's still considered Barbie. She doesn't have to be the sidekick.
I agree. Okay, so then the other change that we made from the original sketch is we had to make a hard choice between fabulous long chinchilla coat or adorable dog. So we're recommending the fabulous long coat. It was a really hard call.
She's not gonna have a dog? Well, how could you sacrifice a chinchilla coat for a plastic dog?
We would have to go to a short coat a long coat.
Why can't you make the long coat and a cheaper dog?
The prop. It doesn't.
I think we should do the dog so we can make a summer one.
Okay. Yoki, you're such a good little executive. Thank you, honey, for that. Why don't you not put fur on the dog?
Even that, there's just no way to get it in the right cost structure.
Well, what cost structure are you trying? Because we just walked by a whole bunch of dolls that you didn't sacrifice their handbag for their pearls. And
we
you
did.
Didn't sacrifice their,
we
well,
did.
they got it.
You didn't see it at this stage, though.
I like the wholesaler. I want the dog and the
dog. That is what I said.
So we need a dog.
Jewelry.
Our girl is fabulous. She has to have a dog.
Okay.
So what possibly more could go wrong than not having clothes for a fashion company's ad campaign? I mean, it's like having, you know, a chicken salad sandwich, no chicken. It's like, how do you make that happen? Cynthia, please tell me that you have something for this ad campaign, please.
Hi, how are you, James?
Good, I'm really scared. I'm like exhausted.
Let me show you what I have and...
This yellow, I don't think, this is a no. I don't think that this is gonna work. I love it. It's very Kimora, like kimono, but I don't think it's gonna work because we're not doing an Asian theme. We're doing more of like a Russian theme. So like all these reds, maybe this print. The thing is that like none of this stuff is really Russian inspired. Do you have anything that might work?
Let me show you some of the one we've been working on.
Okay.
And let me see what you think about it.
Awesome. We like this. This is embroidered, right?
Yes.
But we would love this. It carries through the whole Russian theme. This for sure long. Okay. Can you make this long?
Sure.
You know, if we light it from the back and you see the light pour through it.
So like, do you do it with lining or just?
No lining. This is perfect.
We just make it into a long.
Oh my God, we have to have this.
Okay.
It's amazing. I think that will save the day. Getting down to the wire with this ad campaign, and I think that we really are in good shape now, hopefully.
It's less than a week before our ad campaign, and we don't quite have a budget. It's actually really unacceptable.
I'm not happy today. When I'm not happy, no one's happy.
Why?
I talked to Jack. He told me that we don't have the budget turned in for the photo shoot as of right now, so we don't know how much we're going over budget, but we're about 200 grand over budget. Did you know that?
Yeah, they told me
No one told me that.
James
one.
Is here, he's gonna review all that creative.
Oh, you tomorrow. Know you're in trouble.
Why?
You didn't get my voicemail, left you?
Where?
Oh, I cursed you for filth.
You cursed me for filth?
For filth. I still love y'all, but I cursed you.
Why?
We are almost $250,000 over budget. I don't know why.
Absolutely not.
Yes, we are.
No, we're not.
Okay, well, the reason we don't know is because Chandelier hasn't turned in their budget. We have to shoot next week. The we're
budget.
Already at about $750,000.
No, we're not.
We'll get Jack right now. Jack? This morning you told me that we were like $250,000 almost over budget. James is saying that's absolutely not true.
I mean, working my butt off to make everything happen. I don't understand how things got pulled astray.
He says right now the budget we have is at seven or so.
Absolutely not. What
and James is saying absolutely not. But James, even if it was five, the bottom line is, and not just with an ad, in life, James, in life, when you get married, listen to me, if we're planning your funeral, you have to know the budget sooner than 6 days before the event takes place. You
I
should be upset with Chandelier for not having a budget within a week before the shoot. But James, let me tell you this. They do it every time.
Okay.
So then that goes back to your job. Listen, and you being responsible to me for overseeing the ads, and that means that we should have had...
Please don't tell me what I do and what I don't do, because I know what I do. I do a good job. On a day-to-day basis, I perform.
Are you understanding your contribution to what we have to get? That's all we want
it's
you to
a quick
understand.
Fix to a bad
We're
problem.
Not against you, James. That's what you always think. The world is against
I'm not
you.
Saying that you are. I'm not mad at you. I'm just frustrated. I'm screaming because this is just a joke. And do you understand what I'm saying? It's like I'm defending myself for what?
All that steaming and yelling, that doesn't help you.
I should quit. Is
upstairs.
What I should do.
Well, if you quit, James,
but
you
But Kimora, the only reason why I'm here is because of you.
But James.
And that's the truth. And
James.
You know it. If it weren't for you,
James,
I would have quit
if
that
you
place
quit,
and
you end. Quit, and you want to quit, quit. Then you will be a quitter.
Where do I go? I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille.
That's why I told him I'm going to call you immediately. The day of the shoot, there's no clothes on set.
We don't have an ad campaign.
Kimora's gonna be pissed.
I don't know how it got so out of control where everyone thinks that I'm over budget. The most important thing that I'm most worried about is that Kimora is relaxed and has her mind in a good place to go into an ad campaign shoot. I went through everything with a fine-tooth comb and I know we'll have no budgetary problems.
Kimora?
What's up, Bert?
I have good news to tell you.
I inherited $1 billion.
Sorry, can't share that one with you, but I can tell you that you have an ad campaign ready and waiting for you on Tuesday.
What about your budget?
My budget is fantastic. How is yours? My budget is $497.
Nuh-uh.
Mm-hmm. That's great. That's good news.
And we're under budget.
I've worked with James for years, and he's so great. And he's so funny, and he's so sensitive. We are very much a family unit here. And I mean, does mother never get mad? Do children never get mad? We do. But at the end of the day, I know that James is always gonna deliver. Yeah, James has never not delivered.
What else?
We're gonna shoot for one day, but it's gonna be a really long day. So
that's horrible.
Whenever you fall dead is when you get to leave. I'm off. Gotta go.
Thanks, James.
You're welcome.
Here at the Orpheum, getting ready for the shoot, but we don't have any clothes. Very few things, as you can see.
That's why I told Mom to call you immediately.
I'm at the point now where I feel like there's only so much that I can do. If we don't have these clothes in the next hour, we don't have an ad campaign.
It's not an ordinary fashion shoot when you work with Kimora. Not an ordinary shoot.
That looks different from the normal ad that we've done. Something very artsy looking, you know.
Okay.
Wait, where do I go? I'm ready.
Upstairs.
For my close-up, Mr. DeMille.
Hey, Sal, we want to make cupcakes for Mommy.
Yeah, we want to make cupcakes for Mommy.
Who wants to pour this inside the bowl?
Me. Pour the cornmeal.
There you go.
Whatever it is.
We got to crack eggs. Good job. Good job.
I did it. No, we need some magic. Put that down. Put that. Vanessa. Let me fix it. Yeah. I want sprinkles inside the cake.
We can do that. Perfect. Good job. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it.
No, no! Here's mine.
Here, play for you some more.
Please.
I don't know if she'd be drinking that like that. I'll open the oven. Careful, don't spill it. Okay, here we go. Right inside the oven. Good job, nice job.
Well, I'm stressed out. I mean, it's been a long 2 week period.
And we have yet to get any clothes today. The day of a shoot, there's no clothes on set.
Can you grab the dress for just 1 second?
Kimora's gonna be pissed.
This has been the most stressful shoot that I've ever worked on. I mean, if it's not one thing, it's the other. I really did not want to be the one to bring her the bad news. finally, we got clothes. Basically, I don't have to tell Kimora that it was gonna be a big flop today. And I'm very happy for that because I really did not want to be the one to bring her the bad news.
We're gonna try this on Kimora.
This has probably been the most absolutely stressful shoot that I've ever worked on in my entire life.
I like it, it's fine.
Let's
just go.
We have shoes, we have clothes. We're in a good place right now. I'm very happy.
I love my hair and I love my makeup.
I do too.
It looks phenomenal.
And I love you.
I want to go on the stage and sing.
I want you to do it.
And no, can we go up here?
I'm tired of that.
Come on,
this is for Mommy, so you want to make it look nice. Squeeze it.
Squeeze it.
Chocolate, please.
Hey, oh, it fell off.
This is the first shot of the day. It's very cinematic, it's very Russian, it's very wonderful. I'm very excited.
Oh my God, we finally found Anastasia.
Anastasia. God only knows if we might go over budget with some more shots, but we'll wait and see. But I think that, you know, right now we're in a good place. Walk like a dog.
Bark for Mommy.
Bark like a big dog.
I'm saving it over there for you. There you go.
Give me one. I hope you had a good time at that photo shoot. We love you. Please remember this note all about you that love your widowess Simmons. Now write what I just said.
Enough.
Perfect.
We're on our way to the next shot. It's very George Michael, jeans, motorcycle, Tom Ford, very ethereal, dark, you know, sexy.
So we're setting up for the final shot. The day's gone by really fast. It was very chaotic this morning, but it's all kind of calmed down and going really smoothly.
All right, everybody, it's a wrap.
It's 4:00 in the morning, and it's finally over.
James did a great job. We had a 15-hour day. His budget was not a problem.
We brought in under budget, you know? It's amazing. At the end of the day, I don't look like a liar, and I look like I brought it home to mama.
We're done. It's a wrap.
Season on Life in the Fatling.
You have the Barbie?
Yeah. I'm in LA for just a few days. I need a new home.
Brandon, Cindy,
find me another assistant.
What speech?
Do you have to write a speech?
Come on, Simmons, what? Just find it in here.
we're going to Cannes.
It really doesn't get any better than this. This is the epitome of luxury.
So you know the Baby Phat party in Beverly Hills is coming up. I want to ask you what you're planning to wear.
This is just wrong.
I'm gonna go pray for you.
Beauty is pain. We don't have any clothes.
I need to just break free. Thank you, Jesus. I'm gonna start talking to you all the time. So it's life starring Kimora Lee Simmons.